everybody. Welcome to the holiday episode of Retro Roadmap. Maud Betty's going to take you inside the Macy's in Center City, Philadelphia, and we're going to discover some holiday traditions that live on to this day. Come on, let's go. Meet me at the Eagle. That's what Philadelphians have said for decades when they wanted a common place to meet folks. This is a bronze eagle that has been in the Grant Court here at what used to be the Wanamaker Building and is now Macy's. It's been here since 1904 when it came from the St. Louis Fair. It's a perfect spot to meet your friends or to watch the traditional holiday light show that they have every Christmas season and hear the Grant Court organ. We're going to go upstairs and meet a few folks that are going to tell us more about these holiday traditions. We're here today at Macy's to talk about the Grand Court organ with Peter Conte, who's the organist here. Can you tell us a little bit about this beautiful instrument that you have behind you?
Sure, I'd be happy to. This organ is the largest fully functioning musical instrument in the world. There are over 28,000 pipes back behind that wall, which is now covered by the magic Christmas tree. And it was actually built originally for the 1904 St. Louis World's Fair by the Los Angeles Art Organ Company. John Wanamaker purchased the organ when the fair closed and hauled it here in 13 freight cars. A wonderful picture in the back of 13 freight cars with John Wanamaker, Philadelphia, on it. And he got it here and it wasn't big enough for him, and so he hired 40 full-time men to triple the organ in size, basically. There was an organ shop on the 12th floor of this building. And so it went from 10,000 pipes to over 28,000 pipes. It's a musical international icon, and the cool thing is that Macy's really gets it. The organ was actually, when I first started here, about 15% playable. Macy's came in and the organ is now 100% playable. They appreciate the history of it, and they really have put themselves behind it, which is a wonderful thing. And even to this day, we have two full-time curators, several part-time curators, just to take care of her. We call her Baby.
Excellent. So you play the organ year-round, but especially at this time of year, we've got a little bit more excitement in the building with the light show.
Indeed.
Yes, and tell us a little bit about the history of that.
Sure. The light show was actually put up in the 1950s originally, and it's gone through many, many permutations. The original show had just a tree, then they started adding figurines around it. At one point, there were dancing fountains. They would actually fill the orchestra loft with water. It's frightening to see them do that, because there's an organ right behind you. Organs and water don't really mix. That's all been removed. Macy's came in and actually renovated the entire show. It's now all run on LED lights. Uses a lot less energy, which is wonderful. And they made it so the organ could actually speak through the scrim. It used to be a very heavy velour drape. Macy's fixed all that. So the organ now plays an integral part in the light show. And if I'm here, I can push a button and mute the end of the recorded music track and play the ending live. And that makes the crowd go even more crazy when they hear this amazing instrument envelop them.
Yeah, well, we hope to go wild in just a moment, because I definitely want to get a good spot to see the light show and to hear the organ. So thank you very much for speaking with us today.
It's my pleasure, Ben.
Thank you. Holiday edition of Retro Roadmap. We look forward to hanging out with you later on down the road.